Greetings, Cyberdogs and citizens of the Interbubs! This is ReNDoG coming at you from the foundations of the Molehole Castle in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. I hope all you fantastic humans out there are having a great day. Hope you guys had a great week also. I gotta tell you, man, I've had one of the best weeks of my life for a very long time. And it's all thanks to you guys, man. Jeez, you guys absolutely smashed the like button in the comment section of the first episode. Unbelievable, man. You guys have no idea how much it means to me. Thank you so much for all of the love in the first episode. It's got me super inspired for this series, and I'm so glad to see how many of you guys loved the first episode and how many of you guys are pumped out your minds for this series. Oh man, it is going to be so sweet. Now, since we were last together, guys, I've been pretty busy around here. I'm going to show you some of the changes that I've made, and I'm busy clearing some trees from this little mountaintop over here. Okay, today we have got a very important task. Last episode, we dug ourselves into the side of a mountain. We've got a bed to sleep in. We've got a couple of rudimentary tools and whatnot. But we are lacking on the food front pretty badly. So today I want to try and find a way to get ourselves a little bit more of a consistent supply of foodage. And I got plans, baby. I'm going to create some sort of a food farm or something on top of this mountain. I think it's kind of cool up here, right? Once we clear away all of these trees, we're going to have a pretty decent amount of space to work with over here. And check what else I've done. I've made a connection into the Molehole Castle from all the way up here. Let's go down here. It's a little bit of a janky staircase, but this is going to take us deep into the heart of our mountain. And, well, it's just a very basic tunnel connection. I've got another little room over here, too, that I want to do something with. And this takes us right bang into the center of the Molehole Castle. Pretty cool, right? So we can probably do something cool with that, make like a really cool staircase or whatever. But today, my friends, today we cannot dilly-dally. We need to get ourselves some food. We do have some chicken and some mutton, which is good, but we need to find a way to generate food without killing animals. Because if we start killing all of the animals around Molehole Castle, we're not going to be able to create an animal farm at some point, right? If we kill all of the sheep and the cows and whatnot. And yeah, so today we're going to find a more consistent supply. Now, I also want to talk very quickly about a couple of rules for this series, okay? It's going to be kind of weird, but bear with me. Let me see if I can try and explain myself. In this series, hello sheep, I'm gonna let you live, even though I wanna slay you so bad for your meat. Okay, I'll let you live. You can live a long and prosperous life. Go forth and multiply, little sheep. Go. Go. Dude, don't make me do it. Don't make me do it. Looks like this sheep really likes me, Cyberdogs. I don't know what it is about me. He's kind of looking at my butt right now, which is a little bit disturbing. Oh my goodness. Anyway, guys, let me explain a couple of rules for this series, okay? The first rule that I want to apply to this series is the no using F3 rule. Okay, if we press F3, for those of you guys who might not know, we can actually see our coordinates in the world. We can see that the X, the Y, and the Z shows us where we are in our Minecraft world. I've always thought that using F3 is kind of cheaty, okay? Because then you don't have to like lay down landmarks and you don't have to make roads and stuff like that. You can very easily get around your Minecraft world if you know where you are via the coordinates. So we're gonna make a rule, no freaking F3 in this series, which means we need to set up a couple of beacons around this place so that when we go off into the blue yonder, we'll be able to find our way back to the Molehole Castle and back to our lands, right? So the first little landmark I wanna make is all the way up here. I want to try get rid of some of these freaking leaves over here. Those sheep, you are making a lot of noise, man. Every second that goes by, my instinct to slay your butt is growing. You better take yourself away from here before you become a piece of freaking delicious mutton. You hear me? You stupid mutton face. Anyway, let's clear away a little bit of blocks around here. And this is where I want to set up our very first beacon. I'm just going to make it out of stone bricks and some stone stairs. Something nice and simple, right? Take a look at this. We'll build up like a couple of pillars like this. And then we can stick some torches around them. It's kind of like a light beacon, I suppose, just in case we get lost at night, right? And wherever we are in this area, we will be able to see this beacon. And this beacon kind of represents the Molehole Castle, right? There we go. So we got a beacon over over there. We probably want another one like down there somewhere, just so that if we go adventuring, we'll be able to find our way back. And I want to head off now in this direction, because in the previous episode, I don't know if you guys can remember, man, but we found a couple of donkeys, didn't we? We found a mama donkey and a baby donkey, and they were wandering around the plains, and I would very much like to go on an adventure very soon, and for that, we're going to need ourselves a righteous steed. And I reckon what we should do is head out to that plains and see if we can tame that donkey. Get ourselves a righteous freaking steed that's going to take us off on adventures. And also last episode, of course, we found this saddle, which was very, very lucky to find a saddle so very quickly in Minecraft Survival. It's fantastic. It means you can tame horses and stuff. And horses are really, really good because they don't actually consume hunger when you ride them. And they go much faster than you. And they run up blocks without having to jump. You see, we actually have to jump up this block, right? A horse will just go straight up it. So a horse is a very, very useful animal to have in the repertoire of any Minecraft Survival player. So let's head all the way back to that plains. Let's see if we can find ourselves that donkey, and then we can start working on a little bit of a food farm near the Molehole Castle. So much to do in this episode though, guys. Oh man, I also want to go on an adventure at some point with you guys too. Maybe we'll go caving today. Just a little bit of caving action. See if we can actually find some more iron, because I've actually turned all of my iron into tools right now. We're kind of lacking on the iron. Okay, so there's the first marker. I think we kind of need the second marker, maybe where that sheep is over there. Yeah, that might be a good little spot, and that's going to make it very easy for us to find our way back, right? Just a little bit of old school Minecraft going on down here, guys. Okay, don't judge me. Jeez. Probably wasn't the greatest idea to set up this beacon while the sun was going down, guys. We might have some undead problems over here. Speaking of the undead, I want to speak about the second rule that we are going to be applying for this survival series. We're going to be tweaking the difficulty of the series up to hard. I saw a couple of you commenting in the previous video about the fact that we were on normal mode. And, well, we're going to man up, okay? We're going to play in Minecraft hard mode. I have been playing this game long enough now to hopefully be able to survive in hard mode. So let's crank up the difficulty. Hopefully it's not going to mean my death in these first few episodes. I'm trying to survive to at least the 10th episode without dying. No idea whether or not that's going to be possible. But yeah, there we go. We're playing on hard. And also, while we're here in the Molehole Castle, let's quickly do something about that door, right? We want to try to keep that door closed at all times. So I'm going to make myself a wooden pressure plate, stick it over here, so that when we actually open the door and come in, the pressure plate will close the door behind us. It's kind of lazy, but yeah, it also ensures that none of those undead hordes can get their disgusting rotten butts into my base. That beacon's doing the business now, guys. Absolutely awesome. Now we can very easily find our way back home, right? All we need to do is find this beautiful bay over here, which I absolutely love. Look at this little island over here, man. It's so cool, and the view is crazy. There's some snow-topped mountains over there, and I don't know what that is. It looks like a giant floating egg or something. We're gonna have to go and check that out at some point. But yeah, the sun is setting. We need to head off on our task, guys. We need to find those freaking donkeys, man. I want to get myself a righteous steed today. And they could have wandered anywhere around here. This is a huge plains biome, and the mama and the baby donkey were around here somewhere. Let's see if we can spot them. They might have wandered off into the blue yonder somewhere. I don't want to go too far away from this bay though, because then we're going to get lost. And I do want to find myself back home. Where did we see them? They were around here somewhere, right? Also, I'm out here without a bed, I just realized. Good job, Ren, you freaking noob. Hello, donkeys. Where are ye? I would like to turn one of you into a righteous steed. There they are. Oh no, they've both grown up. I kind of wanted to take the baby, the fresh donkey, but they have both grown up. Who's the mama and who's the son? Are you the mama? This one kind of looks like the mama, doesn't it? This one to me feels more like the son. Okay, well, it's 50-50 either way, and the sun is going down. We need to tame this donkey. Here's how you do it. You got to right-click on it, and then we're going to sit on him. And if he likes us, eventually, hopefully, he'll let us ride on top of him. He's hating us right now, though. Jeez, come on, dude. You know you want to love me. No, he doesn't like us. Dude, the sun is going down. Are you crazy, donkey? We're off to a bad start here. Did he like us? Did he like us? I think he might have liked us. Let's have a look. If we open up our inventory, we should be able to see a donkey inventory. Oh, he didn't like us. Okay, we're going to have to try again. He is hating us right now. Come on, donkey. Dude, why? Why you got to do this to us, man? We can be friends. I'm a dog, and donkeys and dogs are kind of friends. sometimes, I think. We did it! Best friends forever! Yes! That's awesome. Okay, so check this out. We got the saddle, right? We can right-click on him, or if we open up the inventory, yes, we can see. We got a space for the saddle over here. And now we've got a donkey. Nice! Oh, man, that's epic. Okay, dude, we got to get back to the molehole. And he's kind of fast for a donkey, I think. Not exactly the fastest steed that I've ever got in Minecraft, but he's gonna do. He's awesome. Say goodbye to your mum. Oh, this is really bad. I didn't let you say goodbye to your mama. I'll let you say goodbye. Bye, mama. We'll see you later. Be safe out here, okay? There's gonna be a lot of horrible stuff, and maybe we'll come and find you at a later date, but you gotta let your little bird fly. All right, donkey, let's do this. Let's get back to the molehole. We're gonna need to find a name for this donkey, aren't we? I think I'm gonna name him Maximus. And I'm gonna, yeah, that's a sweet name. I'm gonna name you Maximus. The very first car that I had in real life that my dad bought for me, I named it Maximus. So I think that our very first donkey in this series is gonna be named after my very first car that I got when I was 18. And it was a pretty janky car, just like this donkey. Is a pretty janky steed. Maximus, you little beauty. Let's get ourselves back to the molehole. There is the navigation beacon. Okay, nice. All we got to do is follow this gully, and that should get us back. I'm not going to be able to get him into the molehole, though, I think. And I think he's not exactly the greatest jumper. Oh, no. He took an arrow to the butt. No, donkey. Dude, you need to run. You need to run. He is looking real damaged right now. Okay, hold on. Donkey. No. Okay, I'll protect you. There's a skeleton around here. Oh, skeleton, you will not take down Maximus. Get freaking dead. Oh, my goodness. Maximus, my dude, you've taken some arrows to the butt, to the donkey butt. Oh, my goodness, you're turning into a hedgehog now, a donkey hog. All right, let's get you back into the molehole castle as fast as possible. Come on, leaves, please get out of my way. I know, Maximus, I know it hurts. You're missing your mama, and you got an arrow in your butt. Life is hard right now for a donkey, but we're going to get you to safety. Okay, here we go. Beautiful. We got you home. Let me go sleep the night away. Don't go anywhere, dude. I'll be back in a second. We did it, guys. We got Maximus back. Oh, my freaking heart.
Maximus is safe and sound and grazing away quite happily. He's gotten over the loss of his mum quite quickly, guys. Let me tell you, man. It only took one night for him to be a happy member of the Cyberdog pack. Oh, my goodness. There were zombies here, too. I didn't even see them. Oh, that could have gone really horribly wrong. Maximus, really happy to have you back home, my friend. I think what I should probably do is just make him, like, a very quick place to live. Just so that he doesn't get into any trouble. Let's make ourselves a few oak fences over here. I don't know. Let's make ourselves maybe, like, 12. We'll make a nice small little place for him. And we'll also make an oak fence gate so that we can get in and out. We'll probably need to make two of those, I think. Need a few more sticks for this, though. I'm trying to use this thing on the left a little bit more here, guys, okay? Because it makes it much easier to do the crafting. But there we go. Let's just make him like a little donkey keep thing that he can stay in, and we can come and get him when we need him. I guess we could just make it right here, right? Let's just make like a beautiful little pen for him. Oh, I know what we could do. Maybe we could make it like against the wall over here. Yeah, let's do it like this. This will be a little good spot for him. He's already getting in there. Look at that, man. He likes this. Okay, dude, I'll make it for you. Don't you worry. Oh, don't you worry your beautiful little donkey face. I'm so happy about this donkey, man. It's awesome. Okay, let's get him in there. Dude, get into the pen, please. There you go. This is where you're gonna live, and let's just put a gate over there for you. There you go. Beautiful. Get a bit of light up in here for you too. Nice. Maximus, this is now your home, my friend. You recover your wounds, man, because we're gonna need you in a couple of episodes when we go adventuring. Oh, I love this game so much. Oh, man. Now that the dust has settled and my heart rate has returned to normal, let's get down to some crafting, guys. I have just finished clearing away the top of this little plateau, and it's looking kind of sweet. I've got a really great idea for a food farm up here, and I think it's going to turn out real nice, man. Take a look at this. We've got a little mound at the very end of this plateau, and if we look down here, we've got a couple of levels worth of ground, right? And I'm thinking maybe what we should do is make like a little river or something coming out of this little mound, and that river could flow down here, down these different levels, and around that river, maybe we can start growing some crops that we can use to eat. So that is the plan. That's the design that we want to do today. Let's just fix this place up a little bit, give ourselves a little bit more ground to work with over here. Today we're going to be growing wheat. Wheat is a great source of food and energy in Minecraft. Not only can we turn wheat into bread, of course, we can also use wheat to breed sheep. And there's a sheep wandering around up there, and we've seen a couple other sheep around the place. So once we can get a consistent supply of wheat, we can then start farming some sheep. And that's going to give us a nice consistent supply of meat. And then our food situation is going to be sorted. Now, the way that we get wheat in this game, everybody should know, but some of you guys might be brand new. We need seeds. And we get seeds from breaking some grass around here. So let's get ourselves a couple of seeds. Got about 7 seeds, 8 seeds. That's looking pretty good. And we're also going to need some water. Water, obviously, because crops need water to grow. That's probably going to be more than enough seeds for now. I've also collected a bunch of apples from those trees that I chopped down, and I think that donkeys eat apples. I think we can actually get Maximus's life back up. Let's have a look. Are you going to eat this apple? No. I think I might have to take the saddle off you. Maybe he eats carrots, or maybe he doesn't eat apples. Oh, okay. I thought donkeys might eat apples. If we take the saddle off your back, will you eat the apple? Eat the apple, dude. Are you full life? Oh, he's full life. That's probably why he's not eating the apple. Okay. Well, you healed yourself. Good work, Maximus, you donkey of awesomeness. Now, we're going to need ourselves a bit of water over here, guys. And I think I've got a bucket somewhere in Molehole Castle. Let's just have a look. I think it's in the chest of awesome. Yeah, there it is. Let's go get ourselves a little bit of water. We're quite lucky. We got a water source right very close to us down here. We're not going to have to go all the way back to the ocean to get water. There's like a little pond down here. And a gray sheep. Dude, what's happened to you, man? You've seen some pretty bad days. I mean, you do hang out with the undead, and that's probably made you go gray, man. I'm sorry about your life. Don't worry, dude. I'll come and rescue you one day. You can be a member of my sheep farm at some point. But yeah, we got some water, and what we're going to actually need to do is make ourselves a little bit of an infinite water source up here, right? Because we're probably going to need quite a lot of water for our wheat farm. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a little space up here, 4 blocks wide. We can very easily make an infinite water source if we put one block of water over there and then go get ourselves another block of water and put it in the opposite corner, and boom, baby, we'll have infinite water. Infinite water achievement achieved. Very good. Now you can see whenever we take water out of this, it's going to refill that water over there. It's going to make solid water blocks like that, right? Very, very cool. Okay, so let's try and work out a little bit of a stream coming out the side of this mountain. I reckon it sort of comes out of here, maybe. And maybe it can cascade down here, and we can make it go in a nice little zigzag or something like that in this direction. And then it's going to come down onto this level. Maybe we can bring it around like this. I mean, we could just make like a really simple little wheat farm over here, but I kind of want to make everything that we do in the series look a little bit beautiful, you know? I want things to look a little bit great out here, man. Even at the very, very beginning, we can do this. And that looks like it's probably going to be a decent little stream going down there. Yeah, that looks pretty cool. So we can actually start putting some water down here. Let's actually try and block the water off so that it flows down nicely into there. Very nice. That's looking good. Now, I don't think wheat is going to grow next to this sort of water. I think we actually have to make this into solid water. So what we can do is start adding some more water sources like this, just to make the water nice and solid. And I don't know why that isn't solidifying. There we go. We've got a weird thing going on over there. I think we probably need to add a source of water over here, maybe? Yeah, there we go. That's going to make the water solid. We can actually start taking water from here now, too. And we can start filling this up. Jeez, guys, I gotta tell you, man, that mission to get Maximus back into safety, that made me get a sweat on right now. I've literally just finished having a bath before I started recording today. And I'm going to have another one after I record this episode, I think, man. And yes, I like bathing. Don't judge me, okay? The reason that I bath is because, well, I don't have a shower. And I'm always interested to know how many people out there are bath people or shower people. I used to be a shower person until I moved out into my real life hermit house. I moved out here about a year and a bit ago, I guess. And I moved into a house that didn't have a shower. And before I moved out here, I was 100% a shower human. I really disliked baths. I think they took too long. I didn't like the idea of sort of bathing in my own, like, filth, you know? Because I thought that, like, baths, you didn't really clean yourself that much when you bathed. And I always felt like I needed to have a shower after I had a bath. So I wasn't a big fan of baths. But ever since I moved out here and bathing is the only thing that I can actually do, I've fallen in love with the bath, man. I love getting myself into some hot water, just chilling, putting on some music, thinking. You know, it's kind of like quiet time. And I spend a good 20 minutes or so in the bath until my fingers turn to prunes, you know. And I do a lot of my thinking for my YouTube channel in the bath, actually. A lot of the ideas that I come up with happen when I am submerged in hot water. filter with steam rising all around me. You know what I'm saying, dude? You know what I'm saying? You know what? Hey, let me know in the comment section below if you are a bath or a shower person. I'd be very interested to know if I'm the only person that has a bath or enjoys bathing. I know that lots of people like bathing, but even to this day though, guys, after I have a bath, I have to have like a quick shower. I don't, not with the shower, of course, but with the little like spurty thing. You know that baths have like a, what is it called? A shower head or whatever. And once all the water is out of the bath, then I sort of clean, I just give myself a sort of rinsing. And then I feel 100% clean after that. Anyway, I don't even know what I'm talking about right now. This is looking pretty good though. I like it. Okay, so we got some water flowing. It goes down into like a little lake down here. I like it. Looking pretty decent. And what we can start doing now is growing some crops, right? So let's make ourselves some planks. And let's make ourselves a crafting table. And just a couple more planks up in here with some stick action. Let's get some stick action going. And do a little bit of crafting next to our infinite water source. We need something called a wooden hoe, right? Couple of sticks and couple of planks or stones or iron, and this is gonna be the start of a beautiful wheat farm up here. And what we can do is start hoeing the soil around all of this water, right? Looks so cool. I love it, man. And I think we can actually go all the way, I think we can go 5 blocks from the water source before the soil will not get hoed anymore. If we hoe this soil over here, for example, you'll see that it'll actually go back into grass, and we won't, or yeah, back into a grass block, there we go, or back into dirt rather, and we won't actually be able to grow anything there. So I want to try and hoe all the soil around this little river, and then we can start planting the grass. Let's get it done, man. Oh, we got a freaking achievement for that, a CD place. that's kind of weird, man. All right, this grass is going to grow. I want to try get myself a few more seeds though. Let's turn some bones into bone meal and just like speed up the growth of some of these. We can only do 3, but that should give us a few more seeds. Yeah, that sort of tripled our seed intake there, and I just broke this little thing over here too, so good job, Ren. But yeah, I'm gonna do this all the way down this little river, and then we can start working on making the whole place look nice and beautiful. It always amazes me what can be achieved in this beautiful game of Minecraft with just a few basic resources and some janky tools. You know what I'm saying, people? This wheat field is looking absolutely gorgeous, man. I love it. It's starting to deliver the goods too. We're getting a whole bunch of mature wheat now that we can turn into bread, and we have pretty much solved our food situation. All we got to do is break these mature wheat bits, and then we can actually turn them into bread and have a nice consistent supply of food going. Oh man, this is fantastic. We've also attracted a couple of sheep over here. This guy's wandered over to take a look at what's going down. I guess the wheat is smelling pretty good, man. He's getting mighty hungry over there. That sheep that we met up there on the highlands has also wandered down here having a look at what we're up to. But I've been working real hard on making this place look nice and beautiful. Take a look at this, guys. I've been trying to work a little bit on a grotto where the water source is coming from, right? Just using some cobblestone, and that's looking kind of cool. I've also managed to find a bunch of flowers on my adventure to get seeds, and I want to try spend the last part of today's episode just working on the beautification of this place a little bit. I kind of want to get a little bit of green into this back area, so let's get a couple of leaves down, just like we did at the entrance to the Molehole Castle. Just make some bushes and some shrubs around here, right? Just to sort of break up the grayness of what we're working with over here. And I guess I kind of want to turn these things into like stone also inside of the water source. I guess this is like a natural spring or something, right? Yeah, this is like the spring of the Molehole, so to speak. But yeah, let's get rid of this dirt over here. Even though you can't really see it, the OCD is going to kick in something fierce, because water, you know, when it comes out of the side of the mountain, it's coming out of rocks and stuff, right? Let's get another little bit of stone down there. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Now, I wanted to do a couple more things in the field itself, just to try and make it look a little bit more beautiful. Almost broke that crop over there. But do we need any more green over here? I'm thinking maybe just like, well, these are slabs, maybe over there. Yeah, that's a good spot. Beautiful. Yeah, that looks good. And maybe we can get some flower action in here too, right? Maybe we get like a nice little oxeye over there. And there looks to be another spot over here. Maybe we get another oxeye up there. And maybe we get an azure bluet, which is my favorite flower in Minecraft. Absolutely love it. And that should add a little bit of color into the grotto when we look at it from afar. Yeah, look at that. That looks so sweet. I love it. Now, I had another idea. I wanted to start making some rock formations inside of the field itself. I know it's maybe not the most practical field at the moment. You know, you probably, like a lot of you out there, will probably just make a field of wheat like this, right? Just a square like this. But I don't know. I kind of like doing it this way. I think it just makes everything a little bit more interesting. It just makes everything feel like a little bit more natural, I suppose. And I kind of dig that, man. I kind of dig that. So maybe we can make like a little rock formation over here. And maybe what we can do is put a little bit of dirt in here. I want to wait for that to go green, though. And maybe we can plant like a little flower up there. And then maybe we have another rock formation back here. Maybe this one is like actually on the side of the mountain. Just to sort of break up the greenness of the area, right? Just to make it feel a little bit more natural. Like I was saying a bit earlier. So maybe we can do this and get a couple of smooth stones down here. Maybe we want to do a little bit of block variation. Where is my freaking andesite? I think it's all up in that this little work chest over here. But guys, I'm super happy with how the molehole is turning out, man. I think it's starting to look really, really snazzy. And yeah, like I said, man, there's no need to, you know, go completely crazy with resources all the way at the beginning of the game. You can actually make very beautiful stuff in Minecraft just with the very simplest of stuff. Let's add a couple of slabs over here, right? Actually, I kind of want this to go green, so we'll add the slab a little bit later, but let's add a little bit of slabbage like this. That's going to make it feel more like it's a rock formation and less like it's just like a pile of stuff in the middle of nowhere. And let's do the same over here, right? Probably want to switch out this. Maybe we'll have a smooth stone over here. That's not smooth stone. That's freaking gravel. Let's get a bit of smooth stone like that and a couple of blocks of slabbage over here, just to give that rock a little bit of formation. Sheep, dude, if you trample my crops, you are going to die. Are you listening to me? We're going to make a contract, you and me, right now. You trample crops, death. Signed, sheep. You got it? Oh, guys, I just remembered. Last episode, we found some pumpkin seeds in that dungeon, right? And I reckon we should get some pumpkins growing up in this business too, man. That could be really, really cool. We've got 3 pumpkin seeds to work with. And I don't really care too much about pumpkins for food. You can make pumpkin pie out of pumpkins. But pumpkins look really, really cool in this game. And I reckon maybe what we should do is grow these pumpkins like near these rock formations that I've got over here. I think that's going to look really sweet. So why don't we put one pumpkin over there. I just want to turn that one into wheat, and maybe we'll put another pumpkin or two back at this rock formation that I've made over here, right? That could look really cool. Now, the thing about a pumpkin is that it needs a block next to it to grow, right? So in this situation, we're probably going to have to get rid of that wheat to grow the pumpkin like that, and maybe we can stick another pumpkin over there somewhere. But I've got a couple more bones over here. Let's see if we can actually get this pumpkin to grow. Let's just bone meal it up to its mature state, and now it's going to pop a pumpkin over there at some point. Let's see if there's another decent spot here for one last pumpkin. I reckon maybe, maybe like up here. Yeah, this could be a nice little spot for a pumpkin over here. Actually, hold on. I want it next to the water, I think. That could be pretty cool. So let's put the pumpkin over here, and let's just get it up to its mature state like that. And then where was the other one that I planted? It was over here somewhere. Yeah, there we go. Hopefully those will grow before the end of this episode. There's one more thing that I want to add into this place. Isn't it looking beautiful? Oh man, it looks so gorgeous. I love it. And there's so much mature wheat here too. I'll collect all of that jazz off camera and make ourselves a little bit of bread. But check this out. I want to add a little bit of sugarcane into this build too, because sugarcane grows really nicely next to water. And I really love the way that sugarcane looks in this game. So let's get a little bit of sugarcane planted over here, I think. There we go. Look at that. It's such a gorgeous green. I just love it. And then maybe we can get another one around here somewhere. Maybe at the base. That's where the pumpkin's going to grow. Maybe we stick it over here, right? That could be a decent spot for some sugarcane next to that flowing water. I mean, that's where sugarcane usually grows, right? Yeah, that looks sweet. And then maybe one more bit of sugarcane down here somewhere. Maybe like, it's got to be right next to a water source. So I don't know if it's going to grow on this location here, but it might. Let's try. Let's just turn this into dirt and let's plant the sugarcane. Okay, so that's going to grow. That's going to look really decent. Let's have a look at this place from here now. That's looking super lush now, isn't it? Oh, man, I love it so much. This is so sweet. This is definitely the most awesome wheat field that I've ever made in my entire life. I want to try something over here, though. One last thing to do today. I'm so addicted to this, guys. I'm trying to make the episodes not really that long so you guys don't have to sit through hours and hours of this stuff, but oh, I just can't stop playing. It's just too much fun. I was thinking maybe what we could do if we just make like a little rock formation here to start with. Maybe what we could do is have like some fences going around here. This is going to stop those sheep trampling our crops, right? Maybe we just take it up to here like that. We don't have to go all the way down, but just a little bit of fence action to stop the sheep from damaging my stuff over here. Do I have an axe? Yeah, let's sort of clean this up just a little bit. I mean, maybe what we can do is even break the fence up just a little bit like this. I don't think the sheep can get through here. Well, it's going to be highly unlikely, but yeah, kind of make it look like the fence has been here for a long time, right? This one looks a little bit weird, so let's get rid of that. And maybe we can add a little bit of fence around here like this, because this is where we're sort of walking. And maybe on this side, we can add some fenceage over here, right? Just around the sort of perimeter, so to speak. And we're going to leave it broken like that on purpose. I think that looks kind of nice. I don't really like it when the fences are like sort of connected with each other completely. It looks like a little bit janky in my opinion. But there we go. And this actually gives us a great place to put a little bit of light here too, right? Instead of just plonking torches on the ground, we can actually stick a few bits of light sources up here. And maybe like there's even a decent spot for a little bit of fenceage up here somewhere, so we can get a little bit of light going. Oh, you know what we could do actually? We could put a light source behind. Check this out. Okay, so let's put a little bit of a light source behind these freaking leaves over here. Use the brain, Ren. Use the words. Use your words. We'll stick a torch like that, right? And then let's put a little bit of a leaf block, Ren, leaf block, hello, underneath that leaf block, and at night, that is going to look absolutely gorgeous. We can probably do the same thing over here, right? So let's like dig down a little bit, we'll stick a little bit of a light source down there, and we can get those leaves back on top, and we should have like a really beautiful glow coming out of that little wall there, which I think will look really snazzy. Kind of want to get a few blocks of green over here too. Okay, okay, Ren, put the freaking blocks down, dude, you've done enough, and there the pumpkin has grown too. Oh, beautiful. Let's have a look at that bad boy. Look at that. Look at absolutely gorgeous. I think I'm going to probably leave it here though, guys, or this episode is going to be about 7 hours long, but this is looking absolutely stunning. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I was going to go on an adventure, but I got to tell you, man, getting Maximus back to the molehole took it out of me, and I don't want to see the undead for a while. I just want to make beautiful stuff. And I got to say, this wheat farm, it's absolutely glorious. Hope you love it, guys. If you did, enjoy the episode. Remember to hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed yet, hit the subscribe button. Things are only gonna get better here in Minecraft Survival, and yeah, thanks for watching, guys. ReNDoG signing out, and we will smell you all in the next episode. Sheep, remember the contract, my son.